Hello, Esme. Let's return to The Last Polar Bears by Harry Horse. As you can see, it's snowing outside my window. But let's just crank that snow up to 11, shall we? Booyah! The Last Polar Bears by Harry Horse. Friday the 18th of October, Walrus Bay, the North Pole. My dear child, hurrah, we have landed at last at Walrus Bay. The captain wished me luck and we shook hands. He gave Rue a tin of macaroni cheese. I think he really liked her. We were sad to see him go. The town of Walrus is not a bad place, really. There are a few shops and a mailing station where I can send and receive letters. We went immediately to the mailing station to see if there were any letters for me. I got a postcard from your Uncle Vincent in Australia, who went off looking for gold. It said, "Dear brother, no gold yet, but when I find some, I'll be rich. As it is, I am very poor. Please send me some money. Love, Vincent. P.S. I hope you find the polar bears or whatever it is you are looking for." I sent him £5 and a pair of my best golfing socks. I picked up the key to our new cabin and then we went to the shop called the Freezer Centre and bought some provisions. Our cabin stands on a hill just outside Walrus. It was very dirty inside and seemed quite gloomy. But we soon cleaned it up and lit the stove. It has a bed, three chairs and a table, and a small shed outside for storing wood. It's not much, but it's home. Very tired. We'll write to you tomorrow. Tell your mother that I forgot to pack my woolly hat. Could she send it on to Walrus Bay for me? The address is the mailing station, Wolf Street, Walrus, Walrus Bay, near the North Pole. With love, your grandfather. Monday the 21st of October, in our cabin, Walrus Bay. Dear child, I am sorry that I have not written to you sooner. The weather has been so bad that we were stuck in our cabin. But the last 3 days, I spent most of our time trying to keep the snow out. It manages to get in through the smallest gaps in the walls. And so, when I woke up this morning, my bed was covered in snow. And I had to dig out with the help of Rue. We have only been here for a few days and already Rue wants to go home. She complains about her paws most of the time. I've given her a pair of socks, but when she says they're the wrong colour, and then she won't wear them. Rather relieved that she went to bed, I'm afraid. I should like to begin the journey up to the Great Bear Ridge, but I don't feel that Rue is ready yet. She will take more training than I thought. Feeling a little low tonight. With love, your grandfather. Tuesday the 22nd of August, Walrus Bay. Dear child, this morning I was woken by wolves running across my roof. It was the second time this week, and I must say I'm heartily sick of it. Rue says that if they do it again, she will leave. Where she thinks she's going to go, I have no idea. Whether we like it or not, we are stuck here, and there is nothing we can do to change it. I have explained to Rue the purpose of our expedition, but she has a very short attention span and an even shorter memory. I must have told her 100 times that we are looking for the last polar bears. Went down to Walrus this afternoon to stock up on provisions. We paid a visit to the mailing station and bought a pair of Wellingtons and some blankets. Then we went down to the last store and came out with a lot of things we hadn't needed when we went in. That's what it's like in the last store. You just can't seem to stop shopping. I bought an egg timer, a jar of treacle, 6 get-well cards, a stretcher, a footstool, a packet of jam labels and a puncture repair kit. Rue bought a very crude painting of a rabbit, placed everything on a stretcher, and dragged it back home. Tomorrow we will attempt to go beyond Wolf Point. Tell your mother I have plenty of clean socks and there is nothing to worry about. Wolves very restless tonight. Your grandfather. Wednesday the 23rd of October, Walrus Bay. Dear child, this morning I found some wolves in my woodshed looking for dried fish. I told them I didn't have any and they went away, but came back later with their brothers and sisters and stole 2 pillowcases off the washing line and chewed holes in my new Wellingtons. I repaired my boots with a puncture repair kit and set off for Wolf Point just after lunch. Expedition delayed as Rue refused to go past the wolf shed. They were lying there with my pillowcases and I'm sure they had been drinking old sock because they were singing. What a racket. Rue was as bad though. And even if she didn't want to go past them, that didn't stop her from barking at them and causing a general fuss. Several wolves came out of the shed for a fight, and Rue promptly ran away, leaving me to deal with them. They were so drunk by this time that they began to fight amongst themselves, and I left them to it. All this is Grogman's fault. He shouldn't sell them drink. Eventually, found Rue again and harnessed her up to the trolley. My Wellingtons leaked the whole way up to Wolf Point. The snow up here is very slushy from where the ice caps have melted, and I'm sure the polar bears must be further up, where the snow is firmer. I think that they have gone up to Great Bear Ridge. If they're not there, I don't know where they will be. Turned around at 3 o'clock and went back down the glacier towards the cabin. Went past the wolf shed, but they were asleep. Rue made supper tonight, so I'm feeling rather unwell now. It was a dreadful affair that consisted of last night's leftovers and something that had 5 legs and was very hard to chew. Tell your mother that I am fine. I am 78 years old and I can look after myself. Your grandfather. That's the third part of The Last Polar Bears by Harry Horse. I hope you enjoyed it.